Our today's lesson is that electric potential at the point due to a dipole. Again, here also we have got two cases, axial position and broad second position. Here also we are having two cases. The same as electric field we form, if you remember of a dipole, in the axial position and in the equatorial position. In axial position, the electric field was twice that of the equatorial position. But that is only for a short dipole. Same way, we are this time finding electric potential of a dipole due to a dipole at a point, and the situation is this one. First case, axial of head on position. For this, the diagram will be same as before. This is plus Q, this is at take minus Q, center is O, this is L, this is L. We are having a point P situated on its axial position. This distance is R. Distance of the point B from the center is R. We can name the point as this is A, this one is B. Let that be A and B. So this time we are not checking whether that fraction is present taking place. Why? Because we are dealing with electric potential, which is scalar. For a scalar quantity, we will not bother the direction. So we will be simply adding it. So how many potentials will be there at a point B? Two. Well, there are two different charges. One is plus Q, one is minus Q. If there are four charges, there will be four potentials. If there are three charges, there will be three potentials. Or all total potential will be addition of all. Addition of all. So electric potential at P will act as electric potential at P. That is total potential V equal to getting here VA plus VB. VA plus VB. Potential at point P, V to A and V to B. So I'll write here VA plus VB. Simple addition will take place. Now I'm writing here where VA equal to potential of the point P due to charge A will be equal to KQ by the formula is KQ by R, the distance. KQ by distance is what is the distance from here to here? That will be R minus L. I write R minus L. And don't mark addition. And VB equal to I write here KQ by K into minus Q. I write here K into minus Q by R plus L. Because the second charge at V is minus R. I write minus L. So that these two values I substitute here. VA value will put here KQ by R minus L plus this one I write here K minus Q by R plus L. You are taking common, KQ is common. You get 1 by R minus L minus L minus plus become minus 1 by R plus L. Now you are taking the LCM. This is R minus L, this is R plus L. R plus L will come here. R minus N will come here and continue here. R cancel, minus minus plus 2L, we will get V value will become K, U. Here function will become 2L by R square minus L square. That means 2L cube makes P, so that KP by this R square minus L square. So this is the formula of electric potential in the composition of the axial position. We will not mention anything about the direction, and we will not even show at fraction percent, we will not show, because electric potential is scalar. Electric potential is a scalar quantity. Now here we will apply the condition. When L is much smaller than R, V will be equal to KP by R square. This becomes the formula. For a short dipole, when L is negligible as compared to the distance R, so V will be equal to KP by R square. So this is also a kind of derivation. We may carry 3 marks. This is simple only, and then without marking any direction and all, we will do it. So this is the electric potential at a point due to a dipole in the axial position. We are drawing a dipole. We are showing a point P, distance is R, total these sides, two sides, these sides here, these sides also here, and then we have complete area. Similarly, we are doing the second phase now. Equatorial power, broad side on position. Second case we are doing. Second case, the diagram will come. Therefore, we will make first, and then this second case equatorial position is like this. Here is the point P. We want to find that this distance is R. We want to find the electric potential at the point P due to this dipole. This distance will be X. This distance is also X. The same way we will do, but here we are not checking the positive repulsion is taking place or attraction taking place. We will not bother about that. We will take the addition. Electric potential that we will get in V equal to VA plus VB. Simple addition will take place. Where VA equal to, I will be writing here, VA equal to K cube by the distance. Distance between the charge and the point. The distance I have taken X. We can write X. Here we can write X. Now VA value I put, the value of VA will come K cube by X plus K minus Q by X. These two cancel and answer is 0. So V equatorial formula is 0. V equatorial is 0. Electric potential in the equatorial position is 0. Directly. Because charge is same, distance is same, but charges sign are different and we are going to take the sign. So the answer comes 0. This is a quite important case. Question on this had come in the past, even in IEC. It was like this. They were asking, what is the locus of a dipole of zero potential? What is the locus of a dipole of zero potential? Locus means to know what type of line will get, what type of figure will come. So we say the locus is the equatorial position of the dipole means zero potential in that one. When will get the answer coming zero? Electric potential answer coming zero. When it will come in the equatorial position? Or you can say on the equatorial, the locus is the equatorial line, you can say that. Or you can say the locus is the point, locus is the right bisector of the line joining the dipoles. Right bisector is perpendicular bisector. Right bisector of the line joining the dipoles. I mean these two charges, joining the two charges. Anywhere on this point, anywhere on this line, the electric potential will be zero. Because the charges are equal at opposite side and the distances are equal. So the answer will come always zero. One interesting case is here, that also you can understand. Last time we found relationship between electric field and electric potential. So electric field we can add volt per meter. I hope that this if you remember. E equal to V. Electric field is equal to V by R. I have written like that. Where E is electric field and V is electric potential. So it seems if V is zero, then V also becomes zero. So your question may come like this. Is it possible to have electric field without having electric potential at a point? Or is it possible that the electric potential at a point is zero but electric field is not zero? Electric potential is zero but electric field is not zero. The answer is yes. For all these questions, the answer will be always yes, but you have to give examples and all. So the answer is this case. In this case, what do you see? You see potential is coming zero, V is coming zero. But electric field at this point is not zero. I think we already calculated, I mean derived at the formula last time. And the answer was coming electric field in equatorial position formula was coming Kp by R cube. If you remember it, Kp by R cube it was coming. And for axial position it was coming 2 Kp by R cube for a short time.
So electric field is not zero or non-zero, but electric potential becomes zero. So this is possible. Sometimes they ask a question, otherwise also you just think yourself, or there are possibilities, that's when the question is arising. Question even may come like this: is it possible that the electric field is zero? Electric field is zero, electric potential is not zero. Is it possible? Answer is yes. For all these questions, it is possible, that's when the question arises and they are asking you a question. So it is also possible. What is the example of one such case? They may ask question, give example of one such possibility or one such case. So for that case, where the electric field is zero and electric potential is not zero, we give the example of this figure in any. You can give the example over here like this. Let us take a square. All the charges are equal. Q, Q, Q. And let us take the point P at the center. Center of the square. Center is here, suppose. What is the value of electric field at the point P? I think we have already done this type of problem in the previous chapter. Electric field will come zero because positive repulsion. Positive repulsion, this will cancel it. Repulsion, here also repulsion. Charge is same, distance is same. So, all even, EA, EB, EC, EB, all will be equal and all will cancel each other. Answer will become zero. So, electric field answer will become zero. But what about electric potential? It will not be zero because all of them are positive charges and all four positive quantities will be added. Answer can never come zero. In this case, the electric field is zero. E is zero, but electric potential will come like this. Potential into this, potential into this, potential into this, potential into this. There will be four potentials available. You can name the quantities A, B, C, D. You can add here V A plus V B plus V C plus V D. All simple addition. So all of them are equal value wise. You can add here four times of V A. Four V A value will come K Q by R. R is this distance. If side of the square is A and this is given. KQ by the distance. From here to here, the distance will be how much? Last step we have done already, the entire thing is root 2A. Half distance will come A by root 2. So here are in fact here, A divided by root 2. The root 2 will come here, it will become 4 root 2 KQ by A. Then its electric potential is not zero. And it cannot be zero because all four positive quantities when you add, answer will never come zero. But electric field at the point P is coming zero. So the reverse is also true. Is it possible that electric field is zero, but electric potential is non-zero? It is possible here in this case. So this type of question you can expect. Now we'll do some theories and then we'll do the problems on electric potential, which is quite simple. Formula will be simple. KQ by R, and then we'll be not bothering about the direction. We will not break into components. We will not use the law of vectors, we will simply add them and find answers. Okay. Now, next heading we can give electrostatic potential energy. Electrostatic potential energy. That will denote by U, that value. Electrostatic potential energy is denoted by U. How we define it? We say it is the amount of work done. Every kind of energy has capacity to do work. It is the amount of work done to keep two charges in equilibrium at a distance from each other. It is the amount of energy. So it is the amount of work done to keep two charges in equilibrium at a distance. To keep two charges in equilibrium. So the diagram you can show like this. This is Q1, this is Q2, distance between them is R. We are keeping the two charges in equilibrium. Equilibrium is at rest. That's why the word is used over here is potential energy. So for this, U is equal to be writing here work done. Work done to keep charges in equilibrium.
work formula we have force into the distance, distance is r. Force between them, what is the formula force between them? That will be Ku1, Ku2 by r square into r. R cancels, the answer will become Ku1, Ku2 by r. So this is the formula of electrostatic potential energy. Kq1 Q2 by R. Both formula is Kq1 Q2 by R square, but electric potential energy formula is Kq1 Q2 by R, because R and R square cancel. And what is the SI unit of potential energy? Joule. All thermal energy or work unit is joule. So this will have the unit joule, SI unit. And it is a scalar, all energy, power, work, all of them are scalar. So we will take the sign of the charges. If the charges are one of the charges negative, so this will come negative sign. If both the charges are negative, then you are multiplying negative, negative, then should become positive. If both the charges are positive, this will be a positive potential energy. This can have negative potential energy, depending upon the nature of the charges. In an atom, we have protons and electrons. Protons are positively charged and electrons are negatively charged. So the potential energy of an atom, electrostatic potential energy of an atom will be negative, because positive charge and of proton multiplies with the negative charge of the electron. So positive to negative answer becomes negative. So the potential energy of an atom is always negative. So about that we will be in the section C. In the modern physics, you have to derive formula and all, there will be understanding over there, but now I will be telling you that you can have negative sign, can have positive sign, because it is a scalar quantity. It is a scalar quantity. So, new formula is like this, K, Q1, Q2 by R. Next heading you can give equipotential surface, equipotential. Equipotential surface. Equipotential surface. The word itself is clear. Equi is equal, and potential means potential V. The surface having equal potentials throughout is called equipotential surface. We can say the surface where all the points are at the same potential. Such a surface is called equipotential surface. What is the example of equipotential surface? The surface of a conductor, any type of conductor, like metallic or non-metallic conductors, the surface, the upper surface, the surface of the conductor is always equipotential. Potentials are same on the surface throughout. An equipotential surface also has some properties, some important properties you have to know about the equipotential surface. First one, first property, potential of any points on the surface is equal or same throughout. That is what the definition says. Potential at all points on the surface is are equal. That is the first property. Second property, the work done in moving a charge between two points, between any two points on the surface, equipotential surface is zero. Why it is zero? Because you know the formula, work done formula, we have to move any charge, either Q charge or Q naught charge, formula I wrote there is Q into delta V, is potential difference. So since potentials are equal, that's the difference of potential will come zero. If you write here, V minus VA or VA minus VB, the V and VB are all equal because it is equipotential surface. So equipotential surface will have potential same, that's the difference of potential will become zero. Therefore work done will become zero. This is also an important property. Question may come, mention one essential property of equipotential surface. You say the amount of work done in moving a charge between two points, between any two points in equipotential surface is zero. Third property.
the in equipotential surface, field lines are normal to the surface. Field lines will be normal. The normal is perpendicular to the surface. And what is the reason behind it? The reason behind it was what formula you have, F into S cos theta. What can we know is zero because of this? So F S cos theta. Theta value should be how much to give the answer 0, therefore theta must be 90 degree. What is theta? Theta is the angle between force and the displacement. Displacement is the surface area we can consider over here. So when theta is 90 degree, that is angle between the force and the S is how much degree? 90 degree. So this is the reason behind it. So third property we say, in a equipotential surface, field lines are normal to the surface. These three properties are there, important properties. Once again I repeat, first one is the potential at of any points on the surface is equal. Second one, the work done in moving a charge between any two points in equipotential surface is zero. And the third point, the field lines, that is it comes in entity, the field lines are perpendicular or normal. Perpendicular is 90 degree, the normal is the same, normal to the surface. These three properties are there. Even the question may come objective, that is, what is the amount of work done to move a charge Q or to move a charge of plus 1 coulomb from a point A to B on the surface of a conductor? On the surface of a conductor. We know the surface of a conductor is equipotential surface. Answer you will add directly here, 0. Give reason for it, because this is the reason, because W is equal to Q V naught and Q V naught is 0, because potential is same, the answer will come 0. If question comes, what is equipotential surface, you can write any one of the property as the answer here. You can say the surface where the work done in moving a charge between two points is 0. Such a surface is called equipotential surface. So where I move. If you say the surface for which the field lines are normal to the surface is called equipotential surface, that answer is also correct. If you say that is the surface where the potentials are same throughout is called equipotential surface, that answer is also correct and fine. So this much was the theory portion of this chapter. So now we can do some numericals on this. So numerical problems of electric potential, as I did one question like the square one I showed just now. It can be positive, it can be negative. We will not mark direction. We will simply add them. As many charges are there, so that many potentials will be there. So you have to simply add them up. Suppose they are asking you to calculate. Question says, calculate the electric potential at the center of the following square. At the center of the following square. And they have given a square over here like this. This is plus Q. This is minus Q. This is plus Q, this is plus Q, and this is Q. They are asking, find the electric potential. You have to read the question properly. Whether they are asking to find electric potential or they are asking you to find electric field. So you have to be very clear about the question. Read the question very properly. This time question is asking find the electric potential. The first thing we take in your mind that you don't want to mark. We will not check attraction taking place or inversion taking place. Simple addition will take place. How many charges are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So there will be 4 potential. V equal to, you can write VA plus VB plus VC plus VD. Simple addition. VA value will come KQ by the distance. Distance will be here. You can take the distance as x, and the value of x is actually a by root 2. I can write kq by x. B value I write k minus q by x. Vc value I write k plus q by x, and not here k minus q by x. The answer is coming 0. These two respective potentials are cancelling each other, and the answer comes 0. So that is the answer. Okay. Now next question is that is, find the point of zero potential. Find the point of zero potential on the line joining the charges. On the line joining the charges plus 4 microcoulomb and minus 1 microcoulomb. You have to find the point of zero potential on the line joining the charges plus 4 microcoulomb and minus 1 microcoulomb, separated by a distance 10 cm or separated by a distance 10 cm. Let us take the diagram for this and then you do. This side is plus 4 microcoulomb. I take this and I take minus 4 microcoulomb. Distance between the two charges is 10 cm. Entire distance is 10. You have to find the electric potential on the line joining the charges. Find the point of zero potential. Potential of that point must be zero. So there are two possibilities. The line joining the charges can be between the line or it can be even offset. Line joining the charges. It can be line even either inside or outside. There are two possibilities. First one, I consider the point is situated somewhere in between the line, joining the charges. But remember that the point will be situated somewhere closer to the weaker side. Which one is weaker? Plus 4 or minus 1? Which is weak? I mean, the value of which charge is less? This one. It will be somewhere there, that side. So I will be keeping the point P somewhere there, closer to this. Suppose the distance of this point, I take this side as x. Then what is the distance of the point P from the other charge? The total distance is 10, so I will get it at 10 minus 6. 10 cm I will change in meter. 10 cm will be same as 0.1 meter. So from here the distance will become 0.1 minus x. This distance will be 0.1 minus x. So potential is located at total. V is equal to located at V1 plus V2. Or if you are given the name A and B, you can write VA plus VB. Just now let me have V1 plus VU. Total potential has to be 0. You have to make it 0. That V equal to 0. Because point of 0 potential, the question says. V1, I take V1 over here. I write that K into minus 1 into 10 to the power minus 6. I mean micro. And the distance is KQ by R. V2 value, I take K plus 4 into 10 to the power of minus 6. We are taking the sign of the charges, remember it. By the distance from the other side is 0.1 minus 6. Now we are solving it and finding the answer. So this is minus, this minus thing, and take this side. K 1 into 10 to the power minus 6 by x is equal to K 4 into 10 to the power minus 6 by 0.1 minus 6. Cancel now. K and K cancel. 10 to minus 6 will cancel. We will have to answer only 1 by x is equal to 4 by 0.1 minus 6. Now you can do cross multiplication and find the value of x. 4x is equal to 0.1 minus 6. This will come this way. 4x plus x is equal to 0.1. 5x will be 0.1. Therefore, x value will become 0.1 by 5. Get that 0.02 meter, which is same as 0.02 meter is the answer, which is same as 2 centimeter, which is same as 2 centimeter. If you change into centimeter, the answer is coming 2 centimeter. Therefore, we can conclude the answer. Therefore, point of zero potential. Point of zero potential is at the distance of 2 cm from minus 1 microcoulomb on the line be the charges. So that is concerned. You can see this distance is 2 cm and this distance will come out at. So it is far from the stronger side and closer to the weaker side where the charge is weak, where the charge is small. So it will be situated there. But this is one possibility. And there is another possibility that the point of zero potential may be even situated outside. The line joining the charges, this is the line but outside, not between, but it can even lie outside the charges. Somewhere here, over here, either or over here. The first answer will be, it has to be somewhere here this side, because closer to the weaker side. This is weaker side, it will be somewhere here. If it is here, it will become, this point will become far from the other side. So, you can guess out here, where should be the point of zero potential? On the line outside, on the line joining the charges from outside. So then answer would be somewhere here this side. That means on the right of minus 1 microcoulomb, so on the right side of minus 1 microcoulomb. It cannot be over here. Because this side, if it is here, it will become closer to the weaker, the stronger side. Potential of zero potential will be always towards the smaller side, or towards the weaker side. So somewhere here only it should be. So in that case, how to do the calculation? This distance you can take as x, this whole distance becomes 0.1 plus x. This will be changed out as 0 plus 1 plus x required, 0 plus 1 plus x, plus x, plus x. That will become this 4x minus x will become 3x now. I am just telling you that, sir, though it may not come, but just have an idea only. So 3x is equal to 0.1, so x value will become 0.1 divided by 3. Answer will come 0.033 meter. 0.033 meter. That is 3.3 centimeter outside the line joining the charges from 1 minus 1 microcoulomb. That would be the answer. You can complete it as I told you. But in IC cannot, they will give only one of the possibility. Find the point of zero potential between the line joining the charges. Question may come between the line joining the charges. That's what I want. If they ask you a suggestion that where will be the point of zero potential outside the line joining the charges, will it be on the right of this or minus 1 microcoulomb or the left side of plus 2 microcoulomb? Your answer will be on the right side of minus 1 microcoulomb, because the potential due to minus 1 microcoulomb is smaller. So it will be always towards the closer to the smaller side, I mean the weaker side, where the potential is weak. So this is the type of question you may expect to come in IST. Okay. Now another type of question which may be important, and it came in IST once. Question says, if the potential at the center of the following circle, if the potential at the center of the following circle is 0, find the value of charge Q4. And the question was given like this, and the figure was given like this. We are given a circle, here it was Q1, it was Q2, Q3, Q4. Q1 value was given plus 1 microcoulomb, Q2 value is minus 3 microcoulomb, Q3 value was 6 microcoulomb, and the center was 4. Radius was given 1 meter. Radius was given 1 meter. And you have to find the value of Q4. Q4 is unknown. And question says the electric potential at the center O is 0. Question says that. So how to find? So all potential value is 0. So you can write it like V is equal to K. First we write here V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4. All four potentials depend on 0. Question says V1 value will become like this K. Q1 by the distance. I take the distance of R radius. Here I write K. Q2 by R. K. Q3 by R. K. Q4 by R. K by R you can take common. K by R is common, here it comes, that is Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. This thing is becoming 0. Q1 value you can put, here it becomes Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. 0, q1 value is always 1 magnitude plus 1, so you get 1 plus q2 value is minus 3, you get minus 3, q3 value is 6, and q4 is 1 only. You can find this 6 plus 1, 7 minus 3, 4. 4 plus q4, 4 will come this side, minus 4 is the value of q4, therefore q4 value is minus 4 micro coulomb. The identity will change, all I will get in macro coulomb only. Micro coulomb, 1 micro coulomb, 3 micro coulomb, 6 micro coulomb. The q4 answer will also come in macro coulomb form. The q4 value is coming minus 4 macro coulomb. So this was 1 year IEC question. This is simple. Now another question, another numerical is question says, and electron, this is also an important term, and electron is accelerated. An electron is accelerated by a PD of 100 volt. An electron is accelerated by a PD of 100 volt. Find the velocity of the electron. Question says that. Find the velocity of the electron. And mass of the electron given in the question, even if not given, we know that 9.1 into 10 to the minus 31 kg, the mass of the electron given, and the charge of the electron given 1.6 into 10 to the minus 90. This information are provided in the question. Once again I repeat the question. Question says, an electron is accelerated by a PD of, PD means potential difference of 100 volt. Find the velocity of the electron. So, for this question, we will be finding the answer like this. First, we write work done formula will be equal to QV actually. Q into delta V, potential difference. W is equal to, we will be writing a half MV squared. Work done is equal to kinetic energy. Instead of Q, we write V, and voltage I write capital V. Capital V is the value of voltage. This becomes very important formula to find. Small V is the velocity and this capital V is the value of voltage. If voltage is given and you have to find velocity, you have to use this formula. Half mv squared is equal to AV. Equation you use and make V the subject of formula. The value of V squared will become EV by M. And V value will be root of 2EV by N. This V stands for voltage and this small V is the velocity. So please remember it. This thing will carry on the another chapter also will be using the same relationship. So it will be quite an important relation. We will be doing this. 2E value is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 90. V is the voltage given 100 volt, the rate of 100 volt. Mass of the electron is mentioned here as 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31. And please use calculator and get answer in meter per second. Because I don't have calculator to be used, so please calculate it using calculator and check the answer. Oh, and it should be same for all of you. Using calculator, this calculator answer will come something into 10 to the power of 6. 10 to the power of 6 meter per second will come. So please check the answer. You check the answer. Huh? Okay, this type of question you may expect. And then one more type of question is there. They may ask you like this. Two charges of plus 1 micro coulomb and plus 2 micro coulomb. Plus 1 micro coulomb and plus 2 micro coulomb are separated by a distance 10 centimeters. Are separated by a distance 10 centimeters. Find the amount of work done. Find the amount of work done to bring the charges closer by 2 centimeters. That is the question.
So I explained to you the question, what is happening. Question says there are two charges, Q1 value of circuit is plus 1 microcoulomb, Q2 value is given plus 2 microcoulomb. We are separated by a distance 10 cm.
Question says, how much is the amount of work done to bring the charges closer by 2 cm? You have to bring them closer. That is, new distance between the two charges supposed to be 8 cm. 10 minus 2 closer by 2, that means the total distance left over between them is 8 cm. For this type of question, how we do? There are two methods of doing it. So, first method only will follow the existing here. I will find the potential energy of the system in the first case, U1. Electrostatic potential in the formula given K, Q1, Q2 by R. Distance is, suppose first case, the distance is R1, a ladder. This is case 1. U2 value will become K, Q1, Q2 by the new distance is R2. New distance is 8 cm and original distance is 10 cm. Therefore, W is work will be equal to U2 minus U1. Change of the potential energy, changing the energy will give the value of work done. Change of kinetic energy or change of potential energy will determine the amount of work done. That is the shorter method that will be following that. U2 value, I put this K, Q1, Q2 by R2. Here I say Q1, Q2 by R1. Taking common, A, Q1, Q2 is common. Here you get 1 by R2 by 1 by R1. Now I will substitute the value and find the answer. K value is how much? 9 to 10 to the power of 9. Q1 value is 1 microcoulomb. We will take the sign of the charge also. If there is any charge minus, put a minus sign there. 1 into 10 to the power minus 6, Q2 value is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 6, because micro we are changing, micro we are putting here. 1 by R2 is the new distance in 8 cm, R2 value is 8, that means 0.08, changing in meter. R1 value is 10 cm, that means 0.1. And now we will be using the calculator and finding the answer, and the answer becomes something to you. 2 decimal places, you can write down the answer here. 2 decimal place, you can give the answer here. I don't have calculators, I cannot calculate. Please calculate this. Using calculator, entire thing you can calculate and write down the answer. And please tell me the answer tomorrow of this question. What is the answer you are getting? Even your question may come the other way also. Question may come, 2 charges plus 1 microcoulomb plus 2 microcoulomb are separated by a distance 10 cm in air. Now the distance between them is reduced by 2 cm. Find the change in its potential energy. Find the change in its potential energy. That means W you will not find. You will find U2, U1, U2 will do, then U2 minus U1 value will find. And answer will come same. That is indirectly they are asking you to find the work done. So that way also the question may come on this. So this much is the numerical problem from this chapter. So tomorrow you don't have, but day after tomorrow I'll be starting new chapter, that is Gauss chapter.